The new hover typing feature on iOS 18 will show a floating toolbar above your keyboard to show you what you're typing in larger text, or perhaps in a different color with better contrast so it's easier for you to read. To enable hover typing, we're going to jump into the Settings app and then go on to Accessibility. From here, we're going to scroll down until we find the Keyboards and Typing option, and then you can tap onto the Hover Typing option. From here, there's a little switch we can use to enable hover typing, and we can also customize some settings about it as well. For example, I can change the size of the text as it appears on the screen, to perhaps make it larger or easier to read, and I can even choose the font that it's used as well. I can change in the colors of the text and the background box itself. I'm going to change the background to teal because, well, have you seen my channel? There's a lot of customization options here to make sure that hover text, to make sure that your hover typing box is as readable and as clear to you as it can be. You could also change the position of where it is on your screen. I like mine just above the keyboard, but you could have yours in line where you're typing or pinned to the top. Now that's all been configured, let's jump across to the Notes app and we'll give it a try. As soon as I start typing, you'll notice that new teal box I chose the color remember appears above my keyboard, showing me in real time what I'm typing. If you want to make this bigger or change the font to make it more legible, it's a really useful feature to have. And the great thing is it works right the way across iOS, not just in the Notes app. For example, if I pull down to Spotlight Search, it'll even show up above the keyboard here. In fact, because I'm searching for hover typing, I can quickly jump back to that area in Settings, thanks to the new iOS 18 features, and I can simply turn it off if I wanted to from here. Speaking of new iOS 18 features, I've spent my summer exploring what's new, and I've actually put together a ton of videos, but also for the first time ever, an ebook. I've called it 100 Quick Tips for iOS 18, and you can find it just below this video.